Hey everyone, and really quickly, this is a new start for an episode for me. I don't know if this is going to be a new start for an episode for Simon, but Fraps crashed because it's a butt face, and so yeah, we're just re-going again. So what were we talking about?
I can't remember, but we spent the last 15 minutes complaining about Fraps.
We have. It's so funny.
Yeah, I mean, apoplectic. It's really, really frustrating. There's been a lot of times now where I've lost irreplaceable footage because of Fraps and had to go to apologize to people.
Mm-hmm.
The last Minecraft Ultra Hardcore I was in, which is basically a survival competition.
Okay.
Got to the end of that, 2.5 hours in. Didn't do too badly for my first Ultra Hardcore. I was quite proud of myself. And then I noticed I had no footage.
Ugh.
Yes, exactly.
It's infuriating. Mm. So we won't continue to complain about Fraps. Just know that we love you all enough to respect you and want to give you a good product, but sometimes Fraps makes it impossible.
Yes. And it's... Yeah, I'm perhaps less professional, but as professionalish people, it's very frustrating because we want to do something, we want to do it right first time, we wanted to give it to you guys, and hopefully you enjoy it, or at least not complain too much, one or the other. So it's frustrating, it's annoying, and this is the reason why we go on about it, is because... Yeah, you know, we want to do a good thing for you guys, is because you know it's as much for you. Well, it's totally for you guys as much as it is for us.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you guys get to watch something that's hopefully interesting. We get to stroke our egos. It's fantastic.
Yeah, it feels so good.
Yes. And ladies, when you've got an ego as large as mine, no, let's not go down that route.
You know not to do that to the ladies. They all just swoon.
So I've been building a little bit further while April's been putting her stuff back together, and I'm getting this wall up, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to have these front towers lower, the roof will go across this archway here, and up to the dome as we were talking about there. So, but I need this back wall large enough to put a 5x5 grid of maps on. So we're almost there.
Yeah, I'm going to come check it out. Now, Simon and I discussed it while I was getting all set. What he would like is to make it appear as though the town has been built through a river and not like a canal. So that's what I'm attempting to do here, is to create a more organic shape, just like I did with the lake.
Ironically, if you look over there, there's a river we could have built the town through, but we didn't.
Well, now we've got our own man-made river, and we can use landfill, indeed. And then our malls and such can sink into it.
Indeed, yeah, yes.
It'll be awesome.
Yeah, shopping mall. There's the next build.
Yeah. Oh,
sorry.
It's okay. I'm fine.
You're right down there. All right.
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good. I'm going to actually, I'll go up to, I wanted to look at the river shape anyway, so I'll go up to the top of Swan Towers. Hopefully nobody falls into our sweet river. Don't do it, guys.
Well, what you will find is that there will be a chicken in there who will be flapping gamely trying to get out for the next 6 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And then we take pity on it and kill it, and people tell us off. Two, three, four.
Oh, almost fell.
Two, three, four. Yep, the same height. Excellent.
Perfect, like a cat birthday. Sorry, I've been watching a lot of 30 Rock.
So there we go. Oh, sorry. All right, we'll come in through the foyer, books to the left of us, books to the right. We're going to have a little seating area here, and I've got something a bit special for this corner, which I don't want to tell people just yet.
Okay.
But it should be fun. But the first thing I want to do is make sure 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 We could actually go up one more on that, I think, or should we have the maps on the? Let's put the maps right down to the floor. Okay, but first of all, let's go and get some leather, make some item frames.
That's looks really good.
start putting stuff there.
Yeah, I'm looking at
it. I'm about to do something really horrendous to wheat, so if you're of a queasy nature, look away.
Okay, good. No, it's looking really amazing. It's kind of like this deconstructed. Remember how I was talking about Second Empire? It almost looks like a deconstructed Second Empire, which is pretty cool.
Kind of a little bit of the inspiration there. I think it's hanging around with you, with Simmers in general, playing The Sims, has actually started to give me more of a grasp of the American aesthetic when it comes to building, and I enjoy some of it.
Yeah, I can see that.
It's nice to build the old occasional British house, and I build a lot of those. But it's also nice to do the difference. Oh, yes, my mushrooms. Well, our mushrooms. We picked these up. We found a mushroom island, and we went out and lassoed these guys and brought them out across the nether. Now, this is Ermintroom. Hey, hello, Ermintroom. This is Amunita.
I'm such a dork.
And somewhere in here, there you go, there's Mozzarella.
Yep.
She's shy. You can tell. Yeah, looking away from us. Yeah.
I'm pretty sure I actually got the exact same one that I brought back because she was super friendly, and then she would just stare you down with like a 1,000-yard stare.
Yeah, I've got to be honest with you. I was absolutely amazed by how well Ermintroom loved going through the Nether.
Yeah.
It was, yeah. I think, you know, this was actually her environment. It's just nobody ever noticed. Right, those of you of a sensitive nature, I'm about to do something unspeakable to cows. So
oh no! Here's you. Oh, sorry.
Yeah. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make lots and lots of baby cows and then kill the parents.
Right now I'm showing off Amunita, Ermintroom, and where's Mozzarella?
As I said, she's the shy one. She's at the back somewhere.
Oh, okay. All right. I don't want to go freak her out. But yeah, Amunita just stares you down. She doesn't even look... Oh man, she looks miserable.
I just don't want to know. This is sheep, okay? This is bale of hay where the sheep are, okay? And the sheep just jump up onto it and just go around in circles for a couple of minutes, then jump down. Then the next one jumps on it, goes around in circles for 10 minutes and jumps on it. And I suppose as sheep entertainment goes, it is entertainment, but right.
Did you want for the river to go a little closer to spawn towers, or do you want it sort of to be like a narrow thing?
Not entirely certain. Why don't you go with what looks good?
Okay.
Uh-huh. All right, so babies. So we have babies. We have a rather crowded field, so let's thin them out a little bit. So what I'm after here is... what I'm going to get is plenty of meat, but what I want is leather.
Okay.
And we shall use the leather... Oh, an Enderman has been here.
Uh-oh.
If there's ever a mysterious hole in the earth, it's because an Enderman has come along, picked the earth up, and carried it away somewhere. They like doing it. It's a hobby. I don't know why, but there you go.
Well, whatever gets you through the day.
Indeed!
Who are we to judge? So we're leaving the forest over here, though, so it's going to kind of bend into the... Okay.
All right, that's 11. Let's get a few more of these. It's not quite the 25 leather I need, but I think I've got some in my storage as well. If not, I can always come back and finish this off another day.
Never...
I'm actually surprisingly further along than I thought I was going to be honest with you.
That's because we're whistling while we work.
Indeed.
Mm-hmm. I want to actually whistle. My mouth is super dry, and it would sound wicked bad.
Yeah, I won't whistle because I can't.
Oh.
I've got a gap in my front teeth, and it just makes me sound like, basically like the water's boiling.
Oh, well, there you go.
Okay, so... Let's make some item frames. There's plenty of that.
Okay. Do.
There's the sticks around there.
Sorry.
That's right.
This is fun.
Yeah. So, it beats casual violence for the way to pass the time, doesn't it? Okay, all right, so let's put some of these up. 2, 3, 4, 5. So, all right, well, we need to build a lot more, but as you can see, that's going to be the sort of central layout there, and let's go and get a map to put in there. I haven't had a map on me for quite a while. Not since somebody dug a blooming great hole in the mesa, which I fell down without seeing it.
Whoops. Am I cutting into this little pond next to where the moat is?
Yeah, good question.
Do you want to keep that levee there?
I'm actually thinking of getting rid of the entire pond, to be honest with you, because it just seems to be, it's a bit messy and it's a bit in the way.
Okay.
So, there we go. There's the center of our map. That's where Spawn Village is. That green blob there is me.
Woo!
Yes.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna explore around this and build up these maps so we have a good idea of what the continent looks like. So 3, 6, 2, 4. So that's gonna be sort of 5 kilometers in each direction. So that's about 2 miles, which, yeah, is enough distance to walk on an easy day. Anyone who wants to build outside of that, they can have maps. I think I'm going to make a smaller scale map of Spawn. If I get tired of building, I will probably do that, actually. I'm done with that for a little bit. Let's go and see how April's doing. Let's go and have a look.
Check it out.
Yeah, it's looking good.
Oh. Awesome. Ooh, all the way down.
I'm getting block lag from all the loose earth.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, it's looking nice. And that will go through here, down into this moat. Wonderful.
Should be good.
Yeah. What I'm thinking of doing is actually extending this moat out to the river so the whole thing gets completed later on.
Yeah, that'll be good. This is what I was talking about. I mean, you've got this levee here. Whoa, no, don't die. Don't do it.
Yeah.
But whatever you want. I do kind of want to put a little ground in front of my gate because I keep falling in.
Yeah, but that's one of the reasons, to be honest with you. I thought it might be a good idea.
Well, this would kind of be, if you wanted to fill it in a little bit, I'd like to put maybe some animals here that I can
look at. Why not?
Cool.
Absolutely, why not? But you can see it's a bit horrible. There's a creeper hole here, which has been there right since the start. Yeah.
Yeah. They just keep falling in there?
Well, it's a bit like making clucking good chicken. They would just walk up behind me, and the first thing I'd notice was...
Whoops.
And but I was just looking down there, thinking, I just can't be bothered to fill that in.
I can't believe...
I was terrible.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Sorry, go on.
I can't believe I'm almost eaten through my entire diamond shovel. I'm sorry, continue.
Well, I gave it to you for a reason.
It's just so unbelievable.
Yeah.
You know what? Actually, if you filled in that pond, what would look good is if you had I think you might have been saying that if this creeper hole were filled in with like some water down here.
Yeah, that wouldn't be bad, would it? That'd fill out that space. It'd look quite nice. Put some benches around it, say.
Yeah.
What I'd like to see is perhaps some fences, not some fences actually, some bushes up here. You know, it's all that privet hedge we were talking about. Just to stop creepers and zombies and whatever from walking through this area.
Keep it locked down. But this is, I like it. It's looking really good. I mean, I know I just made it. I'm like, oh yeah, that looks so good. Yeah. Nobody does it better, but I do like it.
Yeah, it's looking good. I like it. And let's get us a bit of colour and some paths and places to sit. Let's make it look like a park. It's going to look great. Thinking of that, I really didn't like the back of Clucking Good Chicken. So I was walking through the village I live in the other day, and I noticed people used to paint adverts on the sides of houses and things like that. And you still see a few faded ones on houses as you walk past. I was looking at one of those thinking, you know, that would actually break things up a little bit. So I made some pictures and put some big pictures up here, making, sort of the idea of it being, you know, adverts and things like that. You know, so I'm presuming that one for Donkey Kong. Yeah, it just breaks it up a little bit, makes it look a little bit prettier.
They look really good. Yeah, I mean, we have these here. We have some really old buildings in our town. Mm. What's the skeleton one selling?
Diet pills.
Diet pills. Oh, well, there we go.
Oh, actually, that's not looking too bad from a distance, is it? The sort of the grey columnar zombie, go away zombie.
Yeah, no, it looks really good.
I shall put a name tag on you saying, hello, my name is Steve, and get you to work and clucking good chicken.
I actually had a couple friends that worked at KFC for a really long time, and mm-hmm. they hated it. Oh boy, did they hate that.
Oh, I can't hardly say I'm surprised, to be honest with you. My apologies to you if you are a fast food operative, but it has never struck me as being many people's ideal job.
Oh, no, it's... It can be awful. It can be. Oops, hi, Zomble. Sup? Don't smack me. Don't smack me. That's rude.
Can you spare any brains?
Mm. Actually, oh, man, my... My efflux just turned back on, so my screen is so orange. So what are you digging here?
I just want to put a pillar in. I'll fill this back in afterwards, because this is your hole. These are your holes to make.
This is my domain.
Yes, I just want to put something under here, because these look a little bit floaty. Mm-hmm. So I'll just put pillar there, and...
Oh, creeper.
No, it's really floaty, so I'll go and get some slabs as well to put under there. Oh, I've got some. Silly me.
Go away, creeper.
But it looks so interesting.
Okay, I'll stay there until you're ready to blow up. There we go. Oh, man, I hate what... Oh, you butt face. Sorry. Just put a hole in the nice ground.
Yeah, they're good at that, aren't they?
They're good at being jerks.
Yes, I think we're gonna need to do an expedition fairly soon to go and find some cats, because creepers don't like cats.
Interesting.
In fact, they don't like many musicals.
Well, I wasn't a big fan of Cats. If I'm being totally honest.
Oh, let's take out this cobblestone because it looks horrible. Let's get rid of that.
I'm trying to drop this dirt. Oh, don't pick it back up. I want to pick up these fences because the creeper blew up the fences. So I need to replace them.
Do you need any help rebuilding them?
Nope, it's okay. I was just... Okay, the fences back.
Need to take all this stuff out too as well soon.
Oh, I'm so excited to see this filled in with water. It's going to be so good.
This, by the way, used to be where all our enchanting and that was done, because I was always going to build the library over the top of it, and I got a bit enthusiastic this morning, so I started laying this out without actually taking the stuff out from underneath it, so this is all going to go somewhere soon.
Okay.
I have space. Yeah, I have a bit of space. Let's start clearing.
This is how it's going to connect to the waterfall, right? You're going to remove those stones. Mm-hmm. Okay. So do you want it just to be a straight kind of moat thing, or?
Oh, I want it to look pretty because people are going to be able to look down and see it. So I actually think a sort of a little bit of a snaky to it, and I'd like to see some bushes and plants and that underneath, so people can look down and see something pretty.
Okay. I'll leave a step up, but I'm just gonna make this a little deeper.
Okay.
If that's okay.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, that's gonna take a little while to get rid of, so
you can always tell me to shove off.
I will tell this zombie to shove off.
Yeah, get away, Zomble.
No brains for you, go away.
I haven't done my loot crate video yet, but I got my loot crate and like it was all this zombie stuff again, and I was like, oh, you're killing me here.
Now, I wonder what made you think of that.
I don't know. It's just, I know people like them, but it's...
I'm starting to think the whole zombie thing is getting a bit overdone.
Yeah, I'm just tired. There are a lot of board games that, oh, for those of you on Simon's channel, I'm also an obsessive board gamer, so sorry about this. but there are a lot of board games that involve zombies now, and it's kind of like, all right, meh.
Yeah.
I'd rather play a game about farming.
Okay, I think that's actually built up enough, the walls. So I kind of need to put some windows in to make those look a bit prettier.
Okay.
And I'm just thinking some coloured glass, not pictures per se, but perhaps patterns. Let's just make it look nicer. So they're sort of around here and around here. And we perhaps put some smaller ones in. So let's say here and here, and we'll chuck some coloured glass. But the first thing I want to do is I want to start putting a bit of the roof on.
Okay.
And I'm thinking dark nether brick might be good for this. So let's see what it looks like. So it's a little purpley color.
Okay. Yeah, that's what you said.
Yeah. So let's stick a little bit of that up and see what it looks like.
I just heard something. Oh, that's another portal I'm hearing. What is that?
Yeah, I'm... Oh, yes. I need a hat. It's not coming off. I can't be bothered to pick it up later on. I'll wear a hat later on, but my hat's gone. My armor is dying. I do love this. This is one thing I love the most out of 1.8 is the ability to dye your armor. It's the leather armor. It just looks so good.
That's cool.
It's a real shame that... leather armor is actually crap, but
you know,
it looks
what
good. That's
you're
all it
styling
really,
and that's the most important thing.
Absolutely, that's precisely,
especially
what I was
since
thinking.
LPing is about confidence.
Yes,
you need that swagger.
Yes. And if there's anything I've got swagger.
Yep. Swagger to spare. Okay, let's see how this. Is that too wide there? I wanted to give it kind of a little...
I'll come and have a look in a sec. I'm in the middle at the moment. I'm downstairs in my chest room trying to think what colors to use.
Okay. I love how you have cacti over here.
Let's pick up some... Okay, I've got an idea. Let's try something out. Let's see what it looks like. If it looks terrible, that's what we've got pickaxes for. So, let's see how we're going. And let's stick our nose into this hole. No,
it'll
yeah,
kind of
good.
Flow out. Ooh, yay.
Yeah.
And then I can always give you a little more space for your crafting and stuff. Apparently, I'm the lake maker. That's what we'll... That's what we'll do.
April, the maker of lakes.
Maker of lakes. Fear me and my lake making abilities.
When we get some plants and some coarse gravel or something down his pathways and some bushes in, it's gonna look really good.
Yeah,
I think.
Excited.
The next step's to get some water flowing through it, which is a bit tedious to do, but taint. The
How
end
we
of the
do
world.
It.
With buckets and patience.
Wow, okay. Buckets and patience.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I have one bucket of water on me.
I'll probably make a few more buckets, and we'll make an infinity spring. It's a great phrase, that. And we'll see how we go from there. But, Minecraft water physics it's fairly safe to say, just completely
weird. Yeah, they're
weird.
A little strange. April, stop digging. Stop it. I just can't help myself.
It's worth pointing out, there is actually no Minecraft equivalent of Australia or China, so stopping at some point, probably a good idea. Let's see what that looks like from the ground.
Eat the chicken. There we go. I didn't even need to eat that chicken. Your farm is so big.
Yeah, it's and it's kind of going to get bigger as well. And I think that's actually horrible. So
what,
back to the drawing
nether
board.
Stone.
Yeah, well, the netherstone lip, if nothing else, is nasty. So I'm going to take that off and have a quick look. I ideally wanted something that spiders wouldn't be able to climb up, but it's not the end of the world if they do. Let's just get rid of this lip.
If they left me alone, I'd be okay with the spiders. You know what? Actually, where it's narrower now, it looks good. Like, if it follows the exact edge, it looks good.
Yeah, I had a feeling it might. Let's take a look at that myself. So, oh yeah, that's much better. If we put a, if we go back to this darker gray for the actual roof, then it's just an accent line across it, I think. Let's try that, shall we?
I'm just gonna stalk you and follow you around for now.
Somebody's bored digging.
I can't do anything else. I dug the river I was supposed to dig.
Yes, have you got a bucket?
Where'd you go?
Okay, I'm just going around the back here. All right, let's make a quick infinity spring.
Okay.
That's going to be a good place to do that. I think here, actually. Okay. And you can just make one yourself. If you dig a 2x2 hole like that, okay? And you put a bucket of water in this corner, and you put a bucket of water in the diagonally opposite corner.
Okay.
Alright, you've now got something that you can never empty. Okay, so you can take as many buckets of water out of there as you want, and they will never empty. So, do you want this little ditch that I dug in
here? Oh, sure, that's fine.
Yeah, okay, all right. So, let's get rid of these.
Oops, I'm in here.
And let's let the water flow, shall we?
I'll get washed away, April. Nope. Woo! Oh, I'm so excited. I'm so excited.
So let's put a bit of water in here. Let's get rid of some of this flow. But now if we just... What you need to do here, okay, it's actually, to be totally honest with you, strategically placed buckets of water will actually create a flowing river for you. Okay, so you might just want to experiment with that. And if you don't want that, then if you just put... bucket of water, next bucket of water, couple across, next bucket of water, a couple across, and so on. You'll actually create a steel river.
Oh, okay.
It's up to you. Just go with what feels fun.
Sure. All right. We'll see. I enjoy a challenge.
Yeah. I'm going to see where you're coming from here. If I just drop one in there. I mean, you get a nice steel bit here with the flow going down.
Yeah.
Yeah. Go with what feels good.
Nice. This is going to be lovely, I say, because I built it.
I'm sure it'll look great. I'm absolutely positive it'll look great.
Oops, hi, drowning. Okay, don't do that.
Our health and safety guidelines say you're only allowed to die of drowning once, or indeed of anything, once. So don't do it twice, at least, because it's terrible for the paperwork. Yeah, all right, let's make some bricks.
Ooh, it's raining. Does rain, or hailing, does rain fill up the, that's dumb.
No. Well, Minecraft water physics are, to be totally honest,
are
they dumb? It's just not realistic. It's a model. But by that definition, it doesn't actually have to be realistic. But it works internally well. This is Minecraft logic. Minecraft logic works well internally, but doesn't actually make sense in terms of the real world.
Okay, fair enough.
It's all part of the fun, as far as I'm concerned.
Crap. Nope. Yeah. No. Oh, my God, April. I'm sucking so badly. Okay.
Let's make my steps a little bit larger so I can get up there again.
Well, I think for being a man and in doing some predominantly female things these days, you're doing really well, which is amazing. Especially, you know, you're not old, but being an older man.
I'm officially one of the girls now, aren't I?
You are. We dub you Sandy.
Okay, that one's going to have to go back into...